Hi everybody, welcome back to my channel, and if you are brand new here, welcome in. So today I'm doing a little bit of a double feature vlog marathon, I guess if you can call two vlogs a marathon, definitely a little bit of an exaggeration there, but I'm going to be reacting to SB19's Chicago Pachtatag World Tour vlog and their Dallas Pachtatag vlog. And I'm super excited because I attended these two shows, and at the time of this recording, it's the 22nd, I believe the Dallas show was 2 months ago. And then the Chicago show was also 2 months ago, but that was the 21st, I believe. So they were back to back. Chicago was the 21st, Dallas the 22nd. So I can't believe it's been 2 months already. So this is kind of a fun little celebration of the like 2 month anniversary of that weekend. Yeah, best weekend of my life. If I could go back to one point in my life and do it all over again, I would choose that. But yeah, anyway, I'm so excited to check out their, behind the scenes look at Chicago and Dallas. And just kind of see what the tour was like through their eyes at these cities. So yeah, without further ado, let's get into Chicago first. I can't wait to bring back the post-concert depression I got over some time ago. So, oh, can't wait to relive all the fun memories. So excited. Okay, let's get into this in 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Ooh, I've been waiting for this vlog. I'm so excited. And I got my boba because it's cozy night in. Get some narrator. Look at them. I love Justin's sweatshirt. Oh yeah, that's so crazy too, because for this one, this is their first show, this tour, where they didn't have their backup dancers in their full production. So I can imagine that they probably have to restructure everything, kind of like the Wyatt tour last year, where when they came to the US, they didn't have their full production. So I'm assuming that they probably had to rework a few things just to get used to the absence of those dancers and the absence of the rest of their production. But they did fantastic though. And I've said this before, these five can fill up a stage for sure. Stell and Josh in one frame like that, please. That's too much. Also, Ken looks amazing. Pablo looks amazing. I'm trying to look at all of them at once here. What does Pablo's shirt say? Hold up. Do not remove the photo from this t-shirt. I wonder where this is. This looks like the ballroom of their hotel. Ken counting the dance. Sleep deprivation. And this too, I think this was also like, they had literally about a day to rest right before their show, because they flew in on, I think, what, a Wednesday? They flew in on Wednesday, which is when I flew in. Then Thursday was their tourist day, and then Friday was their show. So they literally had barely any time. They were coming off of like a 20-something hour flight. So, how do they have the energy?
Please,
if we get a Miss Regine, if we get a Miss Regine cover of Crimson, please get Julianne San Jose to do it, Stell. Ask Miss Julianne to do it. Everyone's so done with them. Please. I love Stell's jokes. I never get tired of them. The way Josh squished him. Oh, so cute.
5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Thank you, Justin. That's cute. The choreo for this was so good. Also, Pablo looks so handsome, but he also looks so dead inside. I don't blame him. They're tired. Yes, Stell.
We're going to the venue where we're gonna perform, and it's our first performance, first stop in the US. And we're so excited. See you, Chicago 18.
Copernicus Center. We got there so early, Katie and I. We were literally like the first people there, and we were like trying to find the entrance.
Guys, gising. Gising para matulog na.
What are you talking about?
You have great news.
Come on, oh my gosh.
Hey, wake up. Hey.
She's speaking English, guys.
Wake up.
Wake up.
Hey.
Oh my gosh.
Hey, guys. Tonight. I'm very happy.
I want that to be my new alarm.
Oh,
my new alarm clock.
To all the Chicagoans out there. To all the Chicagoans out there. Hope to see you guys.
There are still a few tickets left.
The Copernicus was a really pretty venue, by the way. That was my first time in there. It was so cool. Goodness gracious, Stelle. You want to know the crazy thing is, from where we were standing outside the Copernicus, like waiting to get in, we could hear them singing, but we thought that they were playing the soundtracks like inside the theater. So we were all debating, like, is that actually them rehearsing or are they just playing the music in there? But I guess that was actually them rehearsing in there. I don't know. My goodness. This first sound check, though, for Chicago was magical. Look at everybody. Look how cute everybody is! Look at everyone's outfits! Aw, Chicago A-Team really pulled up with these outfits. They looked great. I'm on the other side. Actually, I'm trying to find myself. Where the heck am I? Oh, there's me. Oh my god. I don't know if you guys can see my mouse, but you see this little yellow glowy thing right here? I don't know if y'all can see it, but me, that's me right there. So I basically, for those who have not seen my Chicago vlog, I built a replica of the tank from the first half of the Pog to Tog trailer. It's the one where there's the little plant inside and it's glowing and it's got the little pool of water. I basically made my own version of that and painted a sprout and like did that and then decorated the inside with fairy lights so that when I hit the button on the bottom, the tank lights up. So during sound check and during the concert, I tried not to hold it up too much during the concert because I didn't want to like, you know, be a nuisance to anyone around me. But especially during soundcheck, I had that thing on and I was like waving it. Like, and they did actually see it up close because I brought it on stage with me during the photo op and they did think it was really cool. So I was like, yes, it was all worth it, building that thing. But yeah, that's that glowy thing there is me. This was such a fun thing to share with everyone. I'm back there. Oh, wait, there's Paige and Jasmine. I see them over there. And then there's, do y'all see my mouse? I don't know if y'all can see, but there's me right here. So I didn't actually want to come to the front of the stage because there were so many people. And I was like, I'm going to be front row in Dallas anyway. So there's no need for me to like try to rush up to the front with everybody. I'm just going to stay back for this one. But I just kind of watched everything from the back though. Y'all, I cannot wait for them to come back. Oh, these white outfits are everything. I am so obsessed with their opening outfits. Oh my gosh. Ooh, what a moment this was. Y'all, I miss this already. I know this was like 2 months ago. I don't care. I'm like, whoa, hi Stell. Sorry, that was a great shot of Stell. Okay, anyway.
Or anything else.
Goodness gracious.
Hello everyone. Are you still awake?
All of us running on adrenaline at this point.
Kamusta po kayo lahat? How are you guys? My name is Pablo. What's up, Chicago? It's your pretty boy, Stell.
Hi, Stell. The prettiest.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Justin.
Hello, everyone. My name is Ken, and we are... Yeah.
And before anything else, of course, we would like to welcome you to the Patatag World Tour.
That's so crazy. So I was there for the two first shows in the U.S., both for Wyatt and for this. That's so crazy that I got to be part of that.
As long as you guys do the same.
Promise? Shall we do this together?
Yep.
Can we do this together?
Oh, you guys are really the best. And definitely, this will be a night to remember. So, shall we?
We shall. This is our home.
Oh my goodness.
This is our zone.
The way Josh looks at the other members is so heartwarming. Ooh, Josh's goggles are so dope. And Ken's hat, like that bejeweled hat. I just want to get my hands on some outfits and like DIY them and kind of do my own version of the concert outfits, because I've seen people do stuff like that for Disney characters and stuff called Disney bounding, where they kind of DIY their own closet cosplays of stuff. And every time I see this, I'm like, I love doing Disney bounds and closet cosplays. And I want to do like similar ones to theirs because they're so pretty and so unique. Y'all, seeing La Luna live for the first time was an experience. Oh, that was also an experience. Heavens to Betsy. All the light sticks bouncing in the background. But this was super fun. This is so cool too with the lighting in the background, like there's silhouettes on the stage with all the Chicago 18. That is an amazing shot, for sure. Places next tour, like more cities. I also wonder if they're gonna leave any off next tour, like if they're not gonna do one of the ones they went to for the Pagtatag tour. There they go! Good job. beans. There they go.
Good night, Pa.
Thank you.
Good night, Pa.
Tell me for a second why I thought they were going to get in that U-Haul. I was about to say.
Congratulations, everyone!
Aww. Justin is about to knock out. Oh yeah, no, they had to get right to Dallas. And speaking of Dallas, that is up next. But oh my gosh, I'm still trying to process everything. I mean, I don't really have too much more to say because... I mean, I was there, so I don't have much except to process all the memories of that. Okay, so let's get started on the Dallas concert. This one was super fun. I hope they had fun, too. I know Dallas, you know, isn't too familiar with P-pop or, you know, a lot of foreign pop in general, I feel like. It's not super common, maybe in that part of the U.S., but I will say that the people who did go to the Dallas Con really enjoyed it. I could just tell from the vibe in the room, and I really hope the SB19 enjoyed their time there. I know it's, like, very different from all the places they've ever been to before, especially from the Wyatt tour, but yeah, so let's get started on this. And it is the next morning. Y'all, I was running on literally 3 hours of sleep because I had, right after that concert, I packed, slept for a couple hours, then got on my flight to go to Dallas. I don't know if I would ever do another back-to-back concert again like that if I had to fly that big of a distance. But I bet they were like running on adrenaline and coffee and
video na video. Parang ano ako? Parang mami ko dito. Huh? Taba-taba ako ata.
Parang Josh Cullen Santos, you look fantastic. Stop that. This was a really pretty venue too. It was a lot smaller than the other venues that I've been to. But it was very, it felt very cozy and intimate though, which I really enjoy. I feel like that's a very underrated thing. The stage was really small for them. Oh, imagine if they had gone into the aisles during the show. Oh my gosh.
From Houston, Texas, Louisiana.
Ooh, yeah, people came from all over the South.
Let's move, shake.
The energy. Yeah, this, all that flying rehearsal, and then they had to go out for this photo op. Oh, there's K-pop sis! They're so lovely, they're so sweet. Oh, hello? Hello? Is that me? Hold the phone. Whoa. Nobody move. Wait. Me! Okay. There's me in the tiara, the gold tiara behind Stell. Okay, so that outfit, for those who have not seen my Chicago, or not Chicago, my Dallas vlog, so that one, it was like a white and gold theme, kind of like the second half of the Pog to Talk trailer, where they were all, with Crimson playing in the background, they were all dressed in that white and gold. That was what my day two outfit was supposed to be like, so I think that's kind of what, they kind of like got that when I came around and they saw what my outfit was, they were like, oh, okay, you know, but... Yeah, oh my god, I love that outfit so much. I'm literally, every time I see pictures of it, I'm like, I'm so obsessed with it. I enjoy dressing up for concerts. I think that's the bottom line. It's like, it's fun to sort of cosplay or dress in theme of the concert because it's more fun for everybody, I feel like. But holy crap, that's me! Yeah, and Justin, like, as I was leaving, Justin was like, I really like your outfit. Or he said something to that degree. It was like, nice outfit, or like, I really like your outfit, something like that. But I was very flustered trying to, like, get words out of my mouth. Like, see you guys later, see you at the show. I don't know what I said. It. Oh my goodness. I made it into an SB19 vlog. I have peaked in life. And I was also part of their highlight reels, too, which was super fun. I saw myself in that.
You're not sleepy, guys?
So, Lord, I was more sleepy? I was sleepy, but pure adrenaline. You guys, my heart is racing. This was like... I'm in here somewhere. There's Megan and Brianna, and then next to them is April. Where is she? I think she's in the way. And then I am somewhere next to her. So Megan and Brianna, April and me. So I'm like right in this area. Slay. Hi, Miss Coco Jazz. Look at her and her sister. Oh, there's such a mood. I can see us. Wait. Sorry, you guys. I'm gonna keep stopping and trying to find myself because it's so surreal that I'm actually in one of these vlogs. That is weird. So there's April's sparkly little self here, and there's me in that gold tiara right there in the front. I'm gonna keep going. Forgive me if I keep stopping trying to find myself. I'm sorry. I'm so excited to be in this. There's K-pop sis getting a picture with Josh.
1, 2, 3.
I also love these beige outfits too. That's so crazy, they match the venue in a weird way. Oh, is Pao not feeling good that day?
I made a glass, my mind of stone. Tear me to pieces, skin of bone.
Uh-oh, we're hearing that whole thing again.
I made a glass, my mind of stone. Tear me to pieces, skin of bone.
He makes it look so easy. Also, when are we getting a full cover of lovely Mr. Ken Susan? When are we getting a full cover of that? Please, pretty please. What do I have to do for a full cover of that? Did y'all see how... Look at the way Josh and Stell do that. That is so satisfying to watch. This. Oh my god. Oh, that pink cowboy hat is so cute.
Oh, S-P-9-C. Good evening, Dallas 18. I just want to thank all of you for coming here to support us. We love you all, and you know what? We prepared so much for all of you today.
Don't mind me. I'm somewhere in the front. Also, the opening, I have to say, the opening act for this and the Chicago show were fantastic. The names don't come to the top of my head right this second, but they did a really, really good job. So I feel like the opening acts never really get enough credit. And I try to do my best to like take a few pictures of them or a video of them or something just because I think they deserve credit. Sometimes I forget and I feel really bad about it, but they did great. I was on a roll. Yeah, I remember that. Goodness.
You two turn up the heat and I'll burn y'all till I die. Yeah.
Oh, he launched that. Phew, it's disappeared.
I'm killing you, so get the hell out.
Ooh, all of this. Oh my gosh. These are some fantastic shots. Y'all, I will never forget this concert ever. This is like one of my core memories as a fan. I'm just really thankful. I was very lucky to be there. I have a video of this.
Let's go.
I'm addicted to the way that you touch me.
He's a good sport. Thank you, Pablo, for indulging us.
Thank you so
Ooh,
much.
At me. Hold on. Wait. I see.
No, don't thank me.
There's me. I'm over here. I don't know if you guys can see my mouse. There's K-pop sis. There's April in the sparkly gold. And then there's me in the sparkly gold shoulder thingies that kept sliding around my shoulders the whole show.
Thank you so much, Dallas 18. May it be the
There's me. Ah, there's all house right there. Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god. That's so crazy. We were literally like close enough to do that to this stage. Like, this is why I love small venues. I know they're more intimate and they don't have room for the bigger, more bombastic productions like the Araneta Coliseum does, but it's really nice to just kind of have that more close interaction for not only just for 18, but between 18 and the boys too. So I was, like I said, very lucky to be in this venue.
Present, future, nothing can set us apart from each other.
Okay, Josh, I see you. And Stell. Hold on a second. Stell and Ken, what are y'all doing over there? Uh-huh. Right in everybody's faces. Okay. Wait, can we talk about Pablo's react? Look at Pablo laughing at them. Pablo's like, what kind of chaos? Oh my god, look at me dance. I'm so sorry, y'all. This is the last time I'm going back. Look at me down here in the bottom right corner. Look at me dancing. Y'all, I was dancing my butt off. Like, my crown kept sliding. Like, my tiara. Hi, there's me right there. Y'all can see April. There's April and there's me right there. And then, of course, behind Stell. I met Danica and her mom. They were also sitting to the other side of us. Our whole front row was so cool. Like, Danica and her mom, me, April, K-pop sis, and then Jazz all the way down with her sister on the other, like, end of our row. Like, our whole row was so nice. Like, it was so nice bonding with everyone and meeting people. Oh my god. Look at me and April behind Stell. I'm like covered by that freaking monitor. Not me seal clapping. Did y'all see my... What is this? Look at... Oh my gosh. Ah, there we are right there. Oh my goodness. Y'all, this vlog is literally just me pausing and reminiscing about everything. I'm so sorry. Oh goodness. Little finger lights. That's so cute that they played along with the finger lights. Good job, guys. Justin took my phone and April's at some point during this song. Okay, wait, do y'all see? Oh, you can't see it too well in this. Stell's little sprout clip on his head, and I will keep bringing this up and I, for as long as I live, but you'll see it maybe when he walks on stage. You can kind of see it. There it is. I'm trying to get a clear shot. There's like a little tiny sprout clip. So I, like I said earlier for the Chicago vlog, I had these little sprout hair clips and I painted them red and like sparkly gold to mimic the one from the Pog to Tog trailer. And I had some to give away. I had a bunch to give away to other 18. And then I kept 5 extra ones to give away to the guys. And I was going to try to do it like for this show at the Dallas show, because I knew I was going to be right there and I was going to try my best to give it to them. And I was so nervous. It took me literally until like this song or sometime, you know, within the near the end of the song. Finally, I was yelling Stell's name because he came close to the edge of the stage. And I handed it to him. It's like a little bouquet of clips. And he was like, oh, for me? And I was like, yeah, I painted them. So I gave it to him. And that's why he has one in his hair. But, oh, he's so cute with that little sprout. Okay, I'm done. Done fangirling. We got to finish this vlog, you guys. I feel like I've told that story about 5 times on this channel. And y'all gonna hear it again. Sorry.
Ngayon nga po natapos na aming Dallas, ano, ngayon Dallas dito para matuwa naman yung mga tao, di ba?
Grabe yung nadalas namin dito.
Grabe tayo yung nadalas namin dito.
They're all ready to sleep.
Kali na, muntik ako madalas dun eh, sa stage.
Madalas ka namang madalas eh.
Good job, guys!
Thank you so much!
Look at them!
So, today...
Does Justin have a little retainer?
Dallas, Texas.
So cute.
We're going to...
Are we getting tourist content? Yes! We love SB19 tourists.
We're going to try.
I went to Six Flags the day after the concert, so I did not get to see the Stockyard part of Dallas, but I did get to see Six Flags, which was super fun.
Technical pool. Yung mga, alam mo sa movies na papasok sa bar. Pero gusto ko yung nakakatakot. Yung paranormal activity walk.
That's what I want to do. Oh my god, oh my god. You guys, okay, this is so random. If I were to ever have, like, some kind of collab with SB19, I would love to go do a paranormal activity thing with them. Like, a paranormal activity walk, like Justin said, or, like, go to a haunted location. I kind of want to go to a haunted location in the Philippines because I've heard so many legends and ghost stories. And I feel like that would be so fun because it would be totally different from a haunted house where you walk through and there's performers to jump scare you. It's going to like an actual paranormal location. And I feel like that would be so much fun to do with them. Yeah, rant over. Yeah, that's so weird. That's like a collab that I'd love to do with them. Oh yeah, keep dreaming, God. Kelly.
Welcome to Texas, baby.
I need to hear him say that one more time. Sorry.
Welcome to Texas, baby.
Thank you, Stel. Billy, Stel's like, that's so out of pocket. Oh, they went to go eat barbecue, didn't they?
Thank you for watching. Hope you find yourself a merry, merry little Christmas.
Okay, this might sound like a really stupid question, but to my viewers in the Philippines, do you guys have anything kind of like this in the Philippines with like the stockyards and the cowboys and everything? I wonder how weird it was for them and the 1Z crew to see all this stuff. Like, is it just kind of like, oh yeah, that's just like an American version of what we have? Or is it something that like they probably would not have ever seen before? I am so curious. If you guys know, let me know down in the comments because I'd certainly love to know. But look at the size of those longhorns. Oh, speaking of longhorns. Oh god, that's so dangerous. Also, Cowboy Josh is a lot.
Sir, make him drop!
Pablo's like, throw him! Knock him off!
Expectation versus reality!
Y'all are delighting way too much in each other's pain. Pablo, extra full rider over here. Josh is doing really well, actually. Pablo, like advertising for used cars. Oh, Justin. You poor thing. Who let him get on that? Yeah, because it's like 90 degrees. Justin's doing a pretty good job, actually. Yeah, I'm surprised. Justin's actually pretty good at this. Alright, Pablo. You were giving so much advice earlier. Show us how to do it. He's crazy. Oh my. Can y'all imagine the people around wondering why this man is yelling? Pablo is about to topple. I just like to thank the 1Z crew for getting footage of this and being like, this needs to go in the vlog. 100% we're not cutting it. Like, y'all are doing the most out here. Oh, that's it? Great way to end the vlog. Oh my goodness. They are so ridiculous and so fun, but I'm sure that they had a wonderful time. I hope they did. I know that they ate a lot of barbecue and everything, but yeah, oh my gosh. What a fun trip down memory lane. I feel like this was kind of like the last piece in the puzzle for as far as media for the Chicago and Dallas shows go. The vlogs are kind of like the closing statement for that, like, you know, we've stamped that close, and now, of course, they're going to go on to their California show vlogs, and then their New York and the DC vlogs, I'm sure, are going to be coming up. But that's amazing. I know, I can't believe that was 2 months ago. Time really just flew. I remember spending the entire summer, like, ever since word of a U.S. tour back in April, the rumors of the Pakdatag tour started going around because of, I think, Star Media or somebody released something saying, hey, they're coming back this summer. Ever since that, I'd been planning for the tour, planning my outfits, planning my travel arrangements, all that stuff, making my outfits, making my props, painting stuff to give away. Like, there's so much planning that goes into it, and it's kind of like leading up to that one weekend, and then it's over so fast before you can even think, and now you're just kind of sitting there like, wow, what do I do? It's a different kind of PCD, because it's something that you've been looking forward to and like something that's been giving you happiness for so many months, and then it's just over. You see all the people that you reunite with, and then it's all done. They all go on to separate shows. We all go our separate ways until the next tour, and it's just kind of like, you know, I don't know. It's such a crazy phenomenon to think about. And I feel like if you don't handle it well, it could lead you into a very bad space of mental health. And I'm certainly, you know, like my post-concert blues are never that serious or that bad to the point where it's an issue. But it's just kind of like this like longing, like, wow, I miss when I had all that time to plan and look forward to something that nice. But on the bright side, though, I can look forward to the next tour whenever they come back, 2024, or 25, whatever the case may be. You know, we're never promised, you know, next year or anything, if COVID has taught us anything. So it's just kind of like, go when you can and take that opportunity to go see them when you can, because you truly don't know what the future might hold and, you know, if what their plans will be for the next coming years. But anyway, yeah, this was super fun. Thank you to the 1Z team, the whole crew that went with them. You guys are so appreciated. I got to meet some of them in Chicago when we stumbled upon the by chance at the Bean. I got to see the boys and take pictures a little bit, and then I got to talk a little bit to some of the crew that was there with them, and I thanked them and I told them, like, you know, you guys are doing a lot and I appreciate that. And I was very happy to be able to verbally say that to their faces, that they are very appreciated, and, you know, we appreciate everything that they do. Because I mean, as incredible as SB19 is, you know, it takes a village to have these kinds of artists go on tour, especially overseas, and to put everything together, the logistics, the filming, the organization, the travel. I mean, it really does take a whole crew, and they do a fantastic job. So anyway, yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you had as much fun as I did. If you like this reaction, don't forget to like, comment, share, subscribe, all of that good stuff. And I will see you guys back for the next video. So until then, take care and have a great rest of your day. Bye, everyone.